her place.
Before it became infamous.
Ellis Spreckles was a huge fan of Spanish architecture.
Realtor Scott Ulrich can tell you all about the Spreckles Mansion and the history here, because since 2007, he's gone through the buying and selling process.
The real rich history of the house totally overwhelms it. This house was a John Spreckles creation. He hired Harrison Albright, who was known for working with steel reinforced concrete.
He explains in 1908, John Spreckles had this Coronado beachfront house built. The 10 bed, 11 bath mansion is spread over about 19,000 square feet of land. It also includes two sunrooms, a courtyard with a pool and jacuzzi, and guest house where royal guests once stayed.
I would tell you it's 19. Probably 28 or 29 when this was built. This is all pretty original.
In 2011, the history was overshadowed by two tragedies. First, the fatal fall of 6-year-old Max Shacknai, the son of pharmaceutical CEO Jonah Shacknai, and the unusual death of his girlfriend Rebecca Zahau, who was found naked, bound, and hanging from this second-story balcony. Zahau's death was ruled a suicide, but her family strongly believes she was murdered by Shacknai's brother.
It was pretty horrific. It was awful for their family and stuff.
Ulrich says he helped sell the house to Shacknai. It's someone he considers a friend. Though he's sensitive to what happened here, he says the tragedies shouldn't take away from all the other years.
People really, really don't very much concern themselves with the past of a house. I mean, the house, you know, what it was like in the past. They're really buying houses for what they see their future in.
Ulrich says owners since then have been happy with the home. Shacknai sold the home in 2011 for $9 million. Years later, it's on the market for $16.9 million with $4 million worth of renovations. He says recently a potential buyer came through.
He had known about what happened here and it didn't, you know, slow him down and coming to look, but he did ask at the end of the showing. He said to Blake, the owner's son was here, and said, did you notice anything or ever feel anything spooky about the house? And Blake said, no, it's been, you know, a house that he and his family come and join, sleep in, all the different bedrooms and use, and there's not been anything scary or weird about it.
As for Ulrich, he says he feels comfortable in this home that is expected to stand here for decades to come.
The house has been on the market for about